Workout started. Steady 6.70 kilometers at 8 minutes per kilometer. Go.
Okay, so I think I have everything dialed in. Excuse me.
Workout resumed. GPS on. Faster.
And the gloves go on. Finally, I'm running. So it's Sunday today, the 1st of December, D1. And Christmas is the 25th.
2 seconds behind.
So I'm going to do the usual stuff, run to the golf course, do a loop, come back, and I will hike all the zone fours that I hear. I might turn the volume down a little bit on the music. I think that's probably a little lower now. It's just with all this clothing,
zone two.
It takes forever to get anything done.
8 seconds behind. Zone three.
All right. So, back to work. Let me just put the phone in my hoodie. Put my glove back on. And carry on running. Well, Norma is at a craft fair today. Her friend Cindy has a pottery studio in her house, and every Christmas she has an open house where she sells her pottery.
14 seconds behind.
Norma went along with her enamel earrings and her feather brooches. I hope they do well.
Steady.
Just about to get a zone four, I would imagine. Ooh. My excited little heart.
There
you go, Samantha. This is the top of the first hill, and my breathing and heart have not got into sync just yet. I'm in zone three, but there's still more hill, still a little more hill. All right, so I can start again. I'm going to have a noisy section a little bit further up here. Somebody must have a very strong Bluetooth signal in one of these houses. I always lose my Bluetooth heart rate around here. Top of the hill. CC Rider. This will be my D1 show. It's called D1. Because it's December the 1st. And Norma was telling me last week sometime, when I asked her, when is Cindy's show? And she said, 1 second ahead. D1. She wasn't being very talkative that morning, so she just said D1. Because what's going to happen after the show is that Norma's going to bring home a crock pot with a spigot that she's using for mulled apple juice. A bit like mulled wine, but just apple juice with spices. Spiced apple. Warm. I have one that I'm using as my brewing finishing container. I'm going to walk a little bit now because I'm coming to the main road. Luckily, a woman has pushed the pedestrian button. So I'm going to try and run across without getting killed. I think I missed my chance. I'm almost at the golf course now. I'm going to do King's Pond first, and then the Million Dollar Hill down, and then around by the rec center and those native obelisks, and then back the straightaway to Wend and Fairways. This is a good cadence for my running. 14 seconds ahead. I'll see ya. I'd be very surprised if I can stay in zone 3 up this little rise.
Zone 4.
Yep, thought so. My heart is so weak, you wouldn't believe it. I think what it is that my legs have lost a lot of strength. So when there is a hill, it immediately puts that load onto my ticker. When you're young, you can tolerate some of these demands. But it would be like driving an old Fiat 500 up a hill. You if you put your foot on the gas pedal, it's not going to go anywhere. It's just going to burn a lot of gas and make a lot of smoke. You're only as good as your engine. That must have been in zone 4. A couple of geese, 3 geese, circling over my head. Zone 4. I'll more than likely see some old friends here. This is a popular spot for me. Zone 5. Yep, King's Pond Ducks is next. Let me do the camera here, seeing as I have it with me. Lots of duckies. Of ducks today. So many ducks today. All right. It looks like it, yeah. Anyway, they're not too worried about runners and walkers, but
no, I don't think they're too afraid of
me. No. That girl's actually had to stop to get by. Anyway.
Zone 1. Zone 2.
As I put my camera away and my gloves go back on.
Zone 1. 44 seconds behind.
All right, I have 44 seconds to make up. That's about the most ducks I've ever seen there.
Zone 3.
D1 could stand for ducks of the first order.
Zone 4.
Zone 4. I better hike again. It makes it a lot easier for me if I obey the commands. Okay. Better get going again. Up the hill. Well, I hope you're enjoying this exciting episode so far. We've heard the ducks. We've heard me yakking with some guy. We've heard Samantha. We've heard the music.
40 seconds behind.
Oh, wow. I better get going. It's not as cold as I thought it was going to be. This is the sort of weather when it might snow. One last big hill, and then I'll be at the top, close to the top of this.
Time 16 minutes 40 seconds. Distance 2 kilometers. Average heart rate 133. Workout average pace 8 minutes 19 seconds per kilometer.
19. So I've got 19 seconds per kilometer to make up.
44 seconds behind.
Yeah. And I've started doing that now. I should be able to do this one in 7 minute 40 pace. But I've noticed that since my hamstring injury has gone away, I'm running a fair bit faster than I used to. Plus the colder weather helps. This is James Heights. I always think of James Daly
44 seconds behind.
When I get here. In fact, I'll take a picture. I'll take a picture of the sign. Might be useful. My pace is going to be a little bit out the window today. James Heights.
Zone 2.
Oops. Just taking a picture of who knows what. Alright, so I better put this thing away and get my act together. Yep, I know, lady, I know. I'm just gonna check that I'm still recording. Yep. Alright, let's talk more action. I feel so good today. Unbelievable. Excuse me, that was my oatmeal. This little water feature has frozen. People have been testing the ice for thickness. There's a lot of rocks on the surface and a few holes. This is almost perfect for running conditions. Nice, damp, chip trail. Slightly downhill. No wind. No rain.
22 seconds behind.
Yep, I made up.
Time for hydration.
22 seconds. In less than half a K. So this is very close to the top of the Million Dollar View. Yeah, it's downhill all the way now.
Steady.
And downhill to the rec center. I hope you don't think I'm being lazy putting the music on, but quite frankly, sometimes the music is... Hi. It's more entertaining than me. For sure. Hello. New house here? That went up very quickly. I won't stop anymore. Just push on.
Zone 4.
Obeying Samantha.
Slower.
Yep, they've done a little bit of landscaping here.
Steady.
There's a runner going by.
Zone 3.
I'm now chasing her down the hill.
Faster.
I'm way off in the distance. I can see two more runners. This is pretty steep. It's about a 45 degree pitch. I can do about zone 4 on a downhill. That's just excitement, I think. The girl is getting away from me.
Zone 4.
That was one of those motorized golf carts. He sent his clubs up ahead. That's another thing that you could use, some kind of robotic mechanism, some sort of artificial intelligence to drive those golf carts. Not the carts, but the golf bags. Hello. The motorized golf bags. They could be programmed to follow you, or follow your phone anyway. So wherever you went, the bag will follow you with your clubs. I don't think you want it to be ahead of you. It had to be very intelligent to know where your ball was.
1 second ahead.
Mind you, you could put a tracking chip in
average
the ball.
Workout average pace 8 minutes per kilometer.
8 minutes per kilometer, so bang on pace. Good morning.
Faster.
She's quite a taskmaster, task mistress. Samantha. She wants me to... I was going to say, she wants me to run up this hill. One thing is, she's egging me on the pace. And the other thing is, she's giving me the old whoa Nelly on the heart rate, which is interesting. It's like Samantha is behaving
12 seconds behind
in a schizophrenic way. She can't make up her mind whether I should be going faster or slower. Anyway, this is the noisy section once again, so I'll break the file here and get back to you on the quiet side. The Vanilla Ice Cream House. Hello. Thank you. So I've got a bit of a climb here. I'm almost halfway back on the straightaway side of the golf course. I have a steep climb now. So I must admit, I'm enjoying this winter phase of my training. I've been doing some pretty valuable hiking and walking.
5 seconds behind.
I have made up most of my time deficit. Hello. Yeah, he was happy coming downhill as I go up. I shall put a link to this YouTube concert. I believe it's set one or set two of some show or other somewhere in the States, I believe. I won't take it out yet again, but as I say, I will post the YouTube link so you can listen to this music without me yakking away.
24 seconds behind.
I think she said 24 behind. So no more climbing. Yippee! It's flat and down. And I will only hike the zone.
2 minutes, 31 seconds. Distance 4 kilometers. Average heart rate 140. Workout average pace 8 minutes 5 seconds per kilometer. Zone 4.
As I say, I will hike the zone 4s. Excuse me. Two porridge burps today. I must be having fun. So Jim and Anthony put out a
18 seconds behind.
I was just thinking show, which appropriately they called We Were Just Thinking. I'll listen to it when I get back while I edit and paste this show together.
Faster.
For uploading. Better get going. I don't want to start running too soon after they liberate me from zone 4, because I'll be right back there again. But it is worthwhile listening to the heart's murmurs. D1, December the 1st. I was actually ahead by a 4 second gap. But I'm hovering around the 8 minute pace, which is what the doctor ordered for me for today.
Faster.
It'll give me the minutes that I need, plus the ride home, to make my 100 minutes 600 minutes, I should say, for the week. C2, my oldest son, is visiting from Kirkland in the States. He took the American Thanksgiving holiday off and came to visit us here.
22 seconds behind.
22 behind. Oh dear. That'll never do. I think you'll hear me back in the green before long. Hi. Yeah. That guy was in his 40s. Healthy young heart. So this is Glacier Place, one of the entrance points when I go to a different shopping area. Okay, I should ignore the fours today, because as I say, it is downhill until I get into the green. I'll be getting within earshot of the ducks pretty soon. Seen these two guys before on the other side. Hello again. I'm actually closing on that young man up ahead. Well, I did say I was feeling good. The training is working. I have become a more efficient runner.
Exactly.
2 seconds ahead. 2 seconds ahead, you see? From 22 behind. Not long ago.
Faster.
I'm going to take my break here. My recording break, I should say. Because I'm getting to the noisy street. Get back to you on Wend. Almost at the top.
Faster.
This is Wend. This will take me all the way to Shorncliffe and then the top of Garnet and then back to my e-bike. Back to pick up another beer kit and some more protein. I need to buy yogurt and cheese. Planning to make a pizza one of these days, seeing as I have a full house of pizza eaters. My yoga class is going quite well, to tell you the truth. It's hard. The woman that does it, I'm not sure of her ethnicity, but she could be Central American or possibly Filipina. But she's probably second generation Canadian by now. All right. She's very professional. She's done this yoga business for a while, but she gets very excited as well. She's clapping and giving us encouragement. It's good. No music, just her and her breathing. There's one other guy in the class. It's just him and me and about 10 women. One of them, I think, is a neighbor from my street, or at least close by. I'm literally less than a kilometer from where I go. And that's Monday. Monday at 6. Tomorrow at 6, I'll be going to yoga. They have done one leaf collection already this year, and another one's coming up potentially next week and thereon. They're never exactly sure when they're going to get to our street, but I don't have a lot of leaves now. The last few windstorms have cleared all the leaves for us, but I have to get them either off the lawn or into the composter or out to the front. Hello. Yeah, they're dragging a tarp full of, well, it's not full of leaves anymore, they're just dumping leaves. So as I get back to Garnet, if I get to the top of Garnet Lane, I will bid you adieu from Sunday and my D1 episode. I will post the link for the music and the video trailer at King's Pond. Bye-bye.